The last day of the gymnastics competition will kick off this afternoon's highlights with the finals of six individual apparatus events. We'll start with the men's floor exercise, where Russia's Kirill Prokopev earned a gold by a sliver over Russia's Hansel Kim. This performance would give the Russian athlete a total of 14.8 in this final event after scoring a high 8.7 from the execution judge. He would earn the gold medal, followed by Korea, and Japan's Watuari Tangagawa would pick up the bronze. Next up is the women's vault event. Canada's Brittany Rogers picked up the gold in this one. Despite having competed in the 2012 and 16 Olympic Games, this will be her first medal at a Universiad. She finished with a total score of 14. Russia's Lilia Akimova finished with a score of 13.983. And it was Russia's Maria Paseka that finished in third with 13.91. Next up is the men's pommel horse. Taipei Olympian Li Chi Kai finished on top of this one with a score of 15.3. Oleg Vernavev of Ukraine ended up right behind at 15.03. So the Taipei athlete absolutely dominating this event after competing at the 2016 Olympic Games. Japan athlete comes in third. The women's uneven bars were up next, and they were fun to watch. Russia's Daria Spiridonova finished with a score of 14.23. Almost a perfect execution here. You can see her landing absolutely sticks it. The judges would give her a difficulty score of 5.7 and execution score of 8.533. Then it was Armenia's Artur Tavmasyan that wowed the crowd. He was ranked ninth in the qualification round heading into this final, and his performance was absolutely jaw-dropping. He ended with a score of 15.025, almost an entire point over the second place finisher. Turkey's Ibram Kolek picked up the silver, and the Ukraine's Oleg Vernavev, he won the bronze. Men's vault was just as inspiring. Dominican Republic's Audris Nin Reyes, 100 miles an hour. Look how tightly he kept that tuck. Sticks the landing, and he knows it. He finishes with a total of 14.783. Just look at his face after he lands. As he hits his chest, he knows that this is a gold medal performance. He pulls out the number one spot. Next up is the women's balance beam event. Canadian Olympian Ellie Black has competed at the 2012 and 2016 Olympics. She won the silver back in 2013 in Kazan for floor and a bronze in beam. She also, earlier in this competition, won the bronze in all around and helped the team for Canada win the silver in the team event. Now this one will be her first gold medal at a Universiad. She was ranked number one in the qualifying rounds heading into this one, and she would stay that way with a final total of 14.133. Japan's Natsumi Sasada picked up the silver, and it was the Romanian athlete Larissa Andrea Idorș that earned the bronze. Moving forward now to the men's parallel bars, it was Japan's Shogo Nonomura who just inched out the Ukraine's Petro Pakniuk. They had the exact same execution score at 9.2, but it was the 0.1 difference in the difficulty score that inched Japan's Nonomura to the gold medal spot. He ended with a total of 15.6. The Ukraine's Petro Pakniuk ended with 15.5, and it was another Japan athlete, Wataru Tanigawa, that ended in third, 15.2. The final women's event here at the 2017 Summer Universiad in Taipei is the women's floor exercise. Romanian's Larissa Andrea Iordaș already won the bronze in beam, and she would add to her collection here with an absolutely beautiful performance on the floor. She was ranked second coming into this final event from the qualifiers, and she would end with a total of 13.8. It was her execution score that you can see how beautifully she executed it there. She got a total of 8.4 for that single score, and it inched her way past Japan's Asuka Teramoda for the gold medal. The men's horizontal bar was the last event here for the gymnastics competition at the Summer Universiad, and it was France's Axel August who led the way. He made a major comeback, being ranked fifth coming into this finals to win it with a total score of 14.166. Now, he competed at the 2016 Olympic Games and now showing how world-class he is. You can see he stuck the landing, and instinctively he knows that this one is his. He ended 5.8 and 8.366 for a total of 14.166, good enough to grab the gold medal. Moving over to the women's diving 10-meter platform finals at the University of Taipei Diving Pool. The Democratic People's Republic of Korea dominated this event, clinching the two top spots. Winning the bronze medal, however, was Canada's Selena Toth, who earned the third spot with this forward 3.5 somersault pike position dive with a difficulty degree of 3.0 in the third round. A beautiful dive by the Canadian, who also won the gold in Guangzhou for the 10-meter synchro dive. It's just the entry that got a little bit sloppy, too much splash on that one. She's awarded 70.5 for that dive. She would end with a total of 329.2 in the finals. Next up is the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, Kim Ang-yang, who would attempt a back 3.5 somersault dive, upping the stakes now to a difficulty degree of 3.3. Kim Ang-yang is a two-time Olympian competing at the 2012 and 2016 Summer Olympic Games. She also won the bronze at the 2015 World Championship in the synchro platform. Watch how tightly she holds that tyke, releases right at the exact moment to go into the water for the entry. The judges award her 77.55. She ends with a total of 335.25. Good enough for the silver medal. Then her teammate Kim Kuk-yang took to the platform to attempt the same dive as Canadian Selena Toth. Kim Kuk-yang was first in the semifinals heading into this one, and you can see why, how precise the execution of this dive exactly is. We could watch it over and over in slow motion and still not be able to find much wrong with it. The judges, they agree, and they award her 81 for that dive, giving her a total of 350.55, and she's going to take home the gold medal. In that number one position, 350.55. Underneath her, 335.25. She absolutely dominated this event. Canadian takes the third, and in fourth spot is another Canadian, Nancy Dick. Kim Kuk-yang is also a gold medalist at the 2015 World Championship in this event, and then she followed it up with a silver medal in the 2017 World Championship in the 10-meter platform synchro. This is her first Universiad and first gold medal here in Taipei. Let's head over now to Tamgang University Memorial Gym, where we will see the finals for the women's 69 kilogram event. First up, we will see the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, Chung Yu Jung. She successfully snatched 97 kilos and in her first attempt with clean and jerk, got up 117. She attempts 121 here and is successful. And in her third attempt, she does try 125, but just cannot get it up. So with a total of 97 and 121, she ends at 218 and wins the bronze medal.
Good lift. 成功. Same way. 重量不变. Number four.
Next was Kazakhstan's Karina Goricheva. She attempted a snatch of 108, which was the heaviest of all the women in this category, and her clean and jerk was 118. She got this one on her first attempt. Her second and third attempt, she tried to get up 122 and just couldn't do it, so she would end with 118 for a total of 226. And although she couldn't put any more on her clean and jerk successfully, only ending with 118, it was Taipei's Hung Wan Tin that beat her by just 1 kilogram with a total of 227. Now her snatch was only 101, so 7 kilograms less than Karina's, but it was the clean and jerk that did her for her. On her first attempt, she tried 120, made it look easy. On her second that you're watching here, 126. In her third attempt, she tried to go big or go home with 136, but just couldn't do it. But doesn't matter, she's already won the gold medal. You can see here how happy she is in front of a home crowd. She's able to win her first gold medal at a Universiade. The men's 85 kilogram event was up next. It featured 11 athletes from around the world. First up, we will watch Korea's Yun-Hak Jin take to the podium. In his snatch, he was successfully able to get up 163. And in his first attempt with clean and jerk at 187, he couldn't do it, but he upped the weight anyway to 191. It's what you're watching here. He gets that one up in his third attempt. He did try 194, but couldn't do it. So he ended with a total of 354, good enough for third place. Next up is Armenia's Andranik Karapetyan. We're gonna go back a little bit to his snatch because he just lifted 170 and set a new Universiade record. In his clean and jerk, he was only able to get up 194, so it did only put him in that second spot. You can watch here in his first attempt, he goes 185, his second is 190, and then finally gets up 194 on that last one. It will be 1 kilogram short of the gold medal. Kazakhstan's Denis Ulanov was up next. In the snatch, he was able on his first attempt to get 165. In his second and third, couldn't get up 170. So in the clean and jerk, he puts on 200 kilograms, and if he pushes it up, he's good for first place. He ends with a total of 365. Kazakhstan took first place, Armenia earned the silver, and it was Korea that won the bronze. Belarus came in a close fourth place. Welcome to the National Taiwan Sport University Archery Field, where the mixed compound team finals, as well as men's and women's individual finals, took place. The compound mixed bronze medal matchup included teams from Taipei and India. First up was Indian's Lovejot Singh. He scored 10 on the first, followed up by his teammate Snehal Vishna Mandey. On the other end, both Taipei athletes scored big and they took the lead quickly at the end of the first. At the end of the fourth now, the Chinese Taipei still ahead as Chen Yixiang pulls back her arrow. She lets it fly, and that will be a victory for Team Taipei. They pull out the bronze medal in the team compound event. Let's move now to the gold medal matchup between the Republic of Korea and the team from Turkey.
Shooting for the gold medal, the team from the Republic of Korea.
It was Korea that took the quick lead at the end of the second, and they kept that lead with a score of 58-48. But a quick 10 points by Turkey's Demir Almagakli tied it up. Now, in the end of the fourth, it came down to the wire. Turkey pulled ahead 153-137. But in the final end, Chaewon So scores a quick 10, followed up by Jong Ho Kim's, and they win it 157-153 after a crazy comeback in the fourth end. Now for the compound men's individual bronze medal matchup between Korea's Taeyoon Kim and Croatia's Mario Vavro. Both are off to a quick start. Vavro takes the quick lead, but Kim comes right back into it in the first end. By the fifth, it is still very, very close. Kim takes the lead, and with a plus nine, it's Vavro's game. He has won the bronze, 143-138 over Korea's Taeyoon Kim. Next up is the gold medal matchup now for the individual men, and it is a rematch between Korea's Jong Ho Kim and Turkey's Demir Almagakli. Almagakli falling behind quickly, but he gets one in there, ties it up at 19. During the second end now, still close. The Turkish athlete takes the lead now ahead. Korea making a quick comeback. It's tied now 127-127 in the final end. And with a beautiful shot, 9 points, he takes the lead once again, but Almagakli ties it right back up. These two would go back and forth this entire end until finally it was Korea's Jung Ho Kim who nailed it and won, eventually 146-145. It went back and forth the entire time, and it's only a 1 point end. Next up are the women's individual compound, and this is a rematch between both Korea and Turkey once again. And this one would have a very similar outcome. Chaeyoung Soo and Yesim Boston go back and forth the entire time, and it ends very close. You can see Boston taking the lead here, 102-96. A beautiful shot there from Soo brings it back, and she gets the lead. 105-102 now, switch to 112. Boston now, she's up. She fires away. That one, not her best now, still leading the way, 141-134. But at the end, it's Korea's Chaewon So who takes it, 144-141. Now for the women's compound individual gold medal matchup. This one was between Korea's Sung Eun-soo and Taipei's Chen Yi-shun. Young Soo puts the first point on the board, able to be tied up though by Shen. The hometown athlete gets the quick lead even in the third, but it's stolen right away again by Song. Story of today's event, it goes back and forth this entire time. The Taipei athlete leading though, going into the fifth end. An absolute stinger there by Korea's Sung Eun-soo wins her the gold medal in the compound women's individual archery event. We'll get over now to some combat. It was the judo women's under 48 kilogram that kicked it off at Hsinchu County Gymnasium. The gold medal matchup was between Japan's Mei Umakita and Brazil's Gabriela Chibana. Neither athlete would be able to score in regular time. You do see there one Shido presented to Brazil, but then as the time clicked on in golden score, someone would have to do something to end this game. Umakita had Shabana on her back. You can see the time starting there. We're at 5 seconds, and once they come up, that will be an ippon for Mei Umakita. She takes the gold medal in women's under 48 kilograms.
The gold medal goes to Umakita Mai from Japan. Flash Noble from Brazil.
Two men then battled it out in the under 60 kilogram category. It was Japan's Taiko Fujisaka taking on France's Olivier Lamar. Both athletes received Shido's earlier on in the match, and then as the time was winding down, it was Japan's Fujisaka that took action. He first got a waza ari, putting 1 point to his name, but he followed it up only a few seconds later with an ippon to win the game. Brazil's Lamar gives one more try, but it just won't go. Japan takes the gold by ippon over Brazil's Olivier Lamar. Watch this, turns his body, gets those shoulders right on the ground. A great move by the Japanese athlete. Then it was the women's open category that took to the mat for the final between Japan's Akari Inu and Korea's Jiyu Kim. It was Kim that got the first Shido in this event. She picked up a second one quite quickly thereafter, but she wasn't the only athlete to get a Shido penalty. Akari Inu, she picked up one as well. And at the same time, it was a Korean athlete who picked up one more. That's three Shidos, you are out. The victory goes to Japan's Akari Inu, the gold medal in the women's open judo category.
The gold medal goes to Inoue Akari.
And then it was the big boys that took to the mat in the men's open gold medal matchup between Estonia's Johan Matisse and Japan's Hayoga Ota. It was Ota that went on to the offensive first, hooking the leg of Matisse, getting him on the ground, scoring one waza ari. He's able to keep Matisse on the ground for the rest of the bout, trying to pin down those shoulders and get an ippon, but Matisse struggling to keep this game alive. The ref now starts the count to keep those shoulders down. Approaching the 10-second mark now. They put the score up there on the wrong side for Estonia. Should be down for Japan. He wins this one by ippon. At 2 minutes and 46 seconds, the gold medal match is done, and Japan's Hayoga Ota wins the gold. Gotta love watching these in slow motion. Great leg hook to start the offensive and get that first point on the board. The judo team events begin tomorrow. The Taekwondo men's under 58 kilogram event kicked off now with the finals between Iran's Hadi Tiranvalipur and Portugal's Rui Bragança. In the first round, both athletes would score one, but in the second round, it was Tiranvalipur who took ahead until Portugal's Bragança came back at him. But in the third round, Tiranvalipur got two quick ones, ended it with one more, and he won the gold medal in the men's under 58 kilogram event. You can see just how happy him and his coach are. It's his first gold medal at a Universiad. The women's under 49 kilogram event now took place between Thailand's Panapak Wongpatnakit and Turkey's Aipik Sadem. Turkey got on the board first in round one. Sadem unable to put any points up in that first round. A nice little kick to the head there, you can see what happened, but Thailand quickly pulls away. Now, Wong Patinakit won the bronze at the 2016 Rio Olympic Games. She also won the 2015 World Taekwondo Championship. So you can see she is a very, very tough competitor, already up 11-4. Turkey Sedum just has a really hard time putting any points up. She gets two in the second round, but wouldn't be able to get any more in the third. Wong Patinakit, though, wouldn't stop there. She gets two more into the third, and she's going to end it at 16-4. She wins the gold medal over Turkey's Ipek Sedum. Then the men's under 80 kilograms final took place between Azerbaijan's Milad Harshanagi and Spain's Raul Martinez Garcia. Harshanagi won the bronze at the 2012 Olympic Games, and he is the 2017 World Taekwondo Champion. He is wearing the blue, and on the other end, it's Spain's Martinez Garcia in the red. The first round, it was Martinez Garcia that took the lead, tied at the second, 2-2. But it was a quick lead now by Harshanagi going into the final. He took two quick points, but Martinez Garcia would not give up. Now 4-3 heading into the final few seconds of this matchup. At the end of it, it was Harshanagi that took it 6-3 to win the gold medal over Martinez Garcia. Finally, the under 67 kilogram women's final took place between Korea's Jandi Kim and Taipei's Chiang Chia Chia. The hometown athlete was the only one to put up a point in the first round. She won the silver in this event back in 2015 at the Summer Universiade in Gwangju, and she was also the 2015 world champion, but she was going against someone who competed at the 2012 Olympics. Kim Jandi able to put up 4 points in round two. Chiang only able to put up two. When the third round came about, Kim Jandi got 6 points, bringing her to 14. It was the Taipei athlete only able to grab two in this one, and it would end with a final score of 14-7. Kim Jandi of Korea won the gold medal. All the medalists from today's finals got up to the podium after the completion of all of the bouts. Just a reminder here, Iran's Hadi Tiranvalipur won the gold in the men's under 58 kilograms. The women's 49 kilogram was won by Thailand's Panapak Wong Patinakit. In the men's under 80 kilograms, leading the way, grabbing that first spot, was Milad Harshanagi. And in the women's under 67 kilogram event, it was Korea's Jandi Kim that took the first spot over Taipei's Chiang Chia Chia.